I thought I'd make a short video about some very strange-looking results in quantum mechanics. The result looks as if quantum mechanics knows what's going to happen in the future, and those future events can affect how things behave now. The experiment that shows this gets called the delayed choice quantum eraser, but it's really just the double-slit experiment with a minor change, so I'll explain it to you. We've talked about how, in the double-slit experiment, a particle will go through both slits and interfere with itself, giving us this pattern. We've also talked about why, if we try to put detectors in to measure which slit the particle went through, it ends up only going through one, causing this pattern instead. So far, though, we've only had detectors that do the measurement exactly as the particle comes through the slits. But what if we moved it so that it measures it after the particle has already finished going through the slits? Well, firstly, can we even do that? Actually, we can, by ever so slightly tweaking last week's experiment, the quantum eraser. I'll explain how that works in a minute, but let's first just find out what happens. When we measure which slit the particle went through, after it's already gone through, we don't get the interference pattern. The particle must know that we're going to measure it later, so it just goes through one slit. This seems crazy, but it gets worse. We can choose whether we want to turn the measuring device on or off, and we can make that choice after the particle has gone through the slits. What happens in this case? If we put the device on, we get no interference, but if we don't, then we do get interference. This is really weird, because the particle couldn't have known in advance whether the machine would be on or off, so how does it decide whether it should go through one slit or both? It's as if it goes through, finds out whether the device is on or off, and then goes back in time and changes what it does. So the measurement in the future causes the particle to act differently in the past, i.e. the cause comes after the effect. That would be really bad news. Thankfully, quantum mechanics explains this result another way. Basically, in quantum mechanics, the particle does in fact go through both slits. That means that up until the point you measure it, it's in a state like this, which is a superposition of this state and this one. Then you measure which slit the particle went through, and say, find that it went through the first one. It's at this point that the superposition dies, and we end up with just this state. You can see how this makes it look like the particle went through the first slit all along. Still, that's very weird, because before the slit got measured, the particle was interfering with itself, but as soon as the measurement is done, all evidence of that is instantly erased. I personally don't like this very much. But hey, at least causes don't happen after effects. I guess that would be way worse. Okay, so if you're interested, I'll now explain the experimental setup for the delayed choice quantum eraser. It's basically just the same as the quantum eraser. If you haven't seen my explanation for that experiment, then you can watch either of these. Okay, so now remember in the quantum eraser, we have a double slit, and there are two measuring devices, M1 and M2. Only by putting together the information from both can we figure out which slit a particle went through. Therefore, if both are turned on, then we get no interference, but if M1 is turned off, we do get interference. Usually we measure M1 first, well before the particle is at the slits. But we don't need to, though. We can delay doing this as long as we'd like, and let the particle go through first. This way, we can find out which slit the particle went through much after it's gone through the slits. So that's all there is to the delayed choice quantum eraser. It's really time I moved on to another topic though, so see you next time.